That's right. What's his line?
Carousel of progress, you can get a view of tomorrow, a model city of the future. It's based on a concept developed by Walt Disney for a community he called Epcot, Experimental Prototype City of Tomorrow. This animated model is a living blueprint of new ideas and systems for future cities.
How would you describe the impact of the invention of the printing press? Give us some instances of what happened as a consequence of this.
It created almost overnight. It created what we call nationalism. What in fact was a public. The older manuscript forms were not sufficiently powerful instruments of technology to create publics in the sense that print was able to do. Unified, homogeneous reading publics. Everything that we prize in our Western world in matters of individualism, separatism, and of unique point of view. A private judgment, all those factors are highly favored by the printed word and not really favored by other forms of culture like radio or earlier by even by manuscript. But this stepping up of the fragmented, the private, the individual, the private judgment, the point of view, all in fact our whole vocabularies underwent a huge change with the arrival of such technology.
Yes. Could I ask you now about the technology which on your view is superseding it and which is having its own effect on our lives, comparable with but of course entirely different in kind to the
Gutenberg technology was in mechanical to an extreme degree. In fact, it originated a good deal of the later mechanical revolution, assembly line style, and the fragmentation of the operations and functions as the very rationale of industrialization.
Yes.
This fragmentation had begun much earlier after the hunter and the food gatherers with Neolithic man. I suppose in an extreme way one might say that Gutenberg was the last phase of the Neolithic revolution. Gutenberg plus the industrial revolution that followed was a pushing of specialism that came in with the Neolithic man, the agrarian revolution, a pushing of specialism all the way. And then suddenly we encounter the electric or electromagnetic which seems to have a totally different principle. Is it, for some people feel, an extension of our nervous system, not an extension of merely of our bodies? If the wheel is an extension of feet and tools of hands, back, arms, electromagnetism seems to be in its technological manifestation. An extension of our nerves and becomes mainly an information system. It is above all a feedback or looped system. The peculiarity, you see, after the age of the wheel, you suddenly encounter the age of the circuit. Yeah. The wheel pushed to an extreme suddenly acquires opposite characteristics.
Yeah.
This seems to happen with a good many technologies, that if they get pushed to a very distant point, they reverse the characteristics.
What difference is the electric technology making to our interest in content, in what the medium actually says?
It's a very calm business, I'm sure, but one of the effects of switching over to circuitry from mechanical moving parts and wheels is an enormous increase in the amount of information that is moving.
Yeah.
You cannot cope with vast amounts of information in the old fragmentary classified patterns. You tend to go looking for mythic and structural forms in order to manage such complex data and moving at very high speeds. So the electric engineers often speak of pattern recognition as a normal need of people processing data electrically and by computers and so on. Need for pattern recognition. It's a need which the poets foresaw a century ago in their drive back to mythic forms of organizing experience.
Well, here we are, a couple of archaic literate men, Gutenberg men, on the television. What is the audience getting from this? Is it listening to what we're saying, or is it feeling the impact of a new electric medium?
There is a book called Is Anybody Listening? It's what worries the advertising man a great deal. The idea of feedback, of being involved in one's, participating in one's own audience participation is a natural, product of this circuitry.
Yeah.
Everything under electric conditions is looped. You become folded over into yourself, into your image of yourself changes completely.
In your other book, the more recent one, where you, Understanding Media, where you go into all this, you use as a kind of slogan, I think, the expression, the medium is the message. Would you like to illuminate
well,
that?
The medium is the message. Would you like to illuminate
well,
that?
I think it is more satisfactory to say that any medium, be it radio or be it wheel, tends to create a completely new human environment. The human environment is, as such, tends to have a kind of invisible character about it. The unawareness of the environmental is compensated for by some attention to the content of the environment. The environment as merely a set of ground rules and as a kind of overall enveloping force gets very little recognition as a form, except from the artist. I think our arts, if you look at them in this connection, do throw quite a lot of light on environments. The artist is usually engaged in somewhat excitedly explaining and new strategies of culture necessary to cope with them. Blake is an extreme case of a man who was absolutely panicked by the kind of new environment that he saw forming around him under the auspices of Newton and Locke and industrialism. He thought it was going to smash the unity of the imaginative and sensory life all to bits. But the artist, what he was insisting upon in his own lifetime became quite a popular and widespread movement later on.
Can I return to television? Because here we are, where whoever's listening to us is also undergoing the impact of television at the moment. On your view, they're all deceiving themselves insofar as they're paying attention to what we're saying, because what's going on is a medium which is in itself the image that they ought to be concerning themselves with, television at the moment. On your view, they're all deceiving themselves insofar as they're paying attention to what we're saying, because what's on your view, they're all deceiving themselves insofar as they're paying attention to what we're saying, because what's going on is a medium which is in itself what's going on is a medium which is in itself the image that they what on your view they're all deceiving themselves insofar as they're paying attention to what we're saying, because what so far as they're paying attention to what we're saying, because what's going on is a medium which is in itself the image that they ought to be concerning themselves with.
The medium of television has many characteristics which have been unheeded. Mostly it is seen under the aspect of movie form. The TV camera does not have a shutter, does not take pictures. Picks up, as radio picks up, the TV camera picks up its environment, handles it, scans it, and the effect of the TV image is iconic in the sense that it shapes things by contours rather than by little snapshots.
Now, this is one of the words that you use a good deal, iconic. I think we better be clear what you mean by
I think of it, again, to tie in with Blake. His whole insistence upon the engraved, the highly patterned and highly sculptured forms and images, that the iconic in that sense is very low in visual quality, very high in tactile quality. Active touch, not cutaneous, but active touch, as the psychologist
says. So you call television a tactile medium?
Iconic medium. Okay. Having much in common with the cartoon for which it is ideally suited, much more well suited,
yes,
than for pictures.
If you feel that we are going to have to come to terms, or we are coming to terms, much more than typographical man, with this kind of instantaneous image, and I'd like now just to ask you about the distinction than typographical man with this kind of instantaneous image. And I'd like now just to ask you about this kind of we are going to have to come to terms, or we are coming to terms, much more than typographical man. We are going to have to come to terms, or we are coming to terms, much more than typographical man with this kind of instantaneous image. And I'd like now just to ask you about the distinction that you draw between different kinds of media within the electric technology. You call some, such as television, cool, and some, such as radio, hot. Now, what does this mean?
It has to do with the slang phrase, the hot and the cool, which puzzles many people. The way it's used in slang reverses the meaning of cool. Cool in the slang form has come to mean involved, deeply participative, deeply engaged. Everything that we had formerly meant by heated argument is now called cool.
Yeah.
In slang. Cool, though the idea that cool it has reversed its meaning, I think has some bearing on the fact that our culture has shifted a good deal of its stress into a demand that we be more committed and more involved in the situations in which we ordinarily work. And
a cool medium is one in which the definition is low and the audience has to work and supply the gaps.
Well, like the cartoon, you see, mentioning before. Yeah, this is real cool.
Yes.
Jazz, as compared with classical music, has many of these aspects of discontinuity and very much room for filth.
track one.